Sue John? Come around this way.
Sometimes you have to move something around and then make a little path.
Preparations, what should I do with them?
Bring them to the pavilion, they're fixing them all there.
Sure. Wait, mercy, man. Excuse me. Oh, sorry, man.
Oh,
We will have to expand the area of Gomerdon, so where will we put all these plates?
Chompa! Tell him how many.
Huh?
Tell Naveen how many.
462.
462!
Go for it, Naveen.
422.
Hare Krishna!
Hare Krishna! I'm gonna get on the other side and video.
Thank you.
All only wanted that, oh, My dear Krishna should be safe. He has long life. So now Jashamati Nandana and you should begin your work.
Jashamati Nandana Rajavada.
Problem to Krishna. This is there. And Giriraj Govardhan becomes so happy by this. Go from all the paraphernalia, all the books, they are to do three, so that quickly we can go there and away. After that, this should be distributed among all the books. Those who are managing everything. All the preparations should be little divided. Those who want to take it to their homes, here and there they can take it. It is as pure as the last. All the preparations. One, two, three, four persons manage to give them on that.
There's tables by the kitchen where you can put all the plates.
Give single not possible.
Three, four plates each person and by the kitchen.
Two, three, four.
Give me one.
আমার বলিতে প্রভু আর কেহ নাই, তুমি আমার মাত্র পিতা বন্ধু ভাই, আমার বলিতে প্রভু আর কেহ নাই। সম্বন্ধ সবে আমার প্রয়াস বন্ধু দ্বারা, আর ধন জন গৃহ দ্বার তোমার বলিয়া রক্ষা করি আমি মাত্র সেবক হইয়া। সেবা মাত্র করি তোমার সংসারে আমি বিষয় প্রহরি।
इसका अर्थ बतलाऊं तो खड़े होकर के माइक ले लो संक्षेप में लोग अच्छी तरह से समझे सामने आ जाता जो सभी लोग देख सकते Try to hear very attentively. The Bhakti Vinod Thakur has written especially for marriage person, family man, for lady devotee and for all male devotee. And you should try to follow and in your daily routine you can follow it. Very important. Go.
ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्निमीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः दिस सॉन्ग रिटन बाय श्रील भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर इज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर ऑल द डिवोटीज हु वांट्स टू प्रोग्रेस इन भक्ति बिगनिंग स्पेशली दोज हु आर इन फैमिली लाइफ श्रील भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर एंड द टाइटल गिवन टू दिस सॉन्ग इज कायिक दैट मीन्स bodily surrender or deha and dehik means my body which has so many limbs organs and also all the things which are related to my body so one by one he is offering and in his heart he is establishing connection with the lord confirming that oh krishna I know I am your servant I should give up all these things I am not meant to live in this world eternally But because of my karma, I'm entangled here. I've understood by the grace of pure devotees your pure message, O Mahaprabhu. But yet, because I have not attained so much purity, so all these things which I have, my wife, my children, my home, myself, my clothes, my dogs, my cows, my house, everything is yours. Amar bolite Prabhu, whatever I say mine is actually yours. And it has no other meaning in my life.
From today, you should have hall like this, promise like this, if you want to be really devotee. That's what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling. He is your Siksha Guru, more than Diksha Guru. Go on.
You are my father, you are my brother, you are my friend, you are my everyone. And keeping this relationship in mind I have relationship with others otherwise I don't have any independent relationship with anyone else in this world you are my friend you are my wife you are my boy you are my daughter you are everything to me and all these relationships which I have in this world meaning my wife my children they are your servant they are not my property I have been engaged and given opportunity to bring them to your service That's what I'm trying.
Also, any disciple is not property of Gurudev. All disciples are property of Krishna, Mahaprabhu. But now they are thinking, we are thinking, and that is why we are going to heaven. So we should not think like that.
And then in the next line he's saying, at least I have understood it theoretically, and now I am practicing it. He's saying, सही तो संबंध सभे हमारा प्रयास आई एम एंडेवरिंग आई एम प्रैक्टिसिंग दैट दिस इज हाउ आई शुड ट्रेन माई सेल्फ दिस इज हाउ शुड आई शुड ट्रेन ऑल द मेंबर्स दैट दे शुड सर्व यू एंड दे शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट एक्चुअली दे आर योर सर्वेंट हाउस ऑल द अदर रिलेशनशिप्स इन द सोसाइटी एंड वाइफ एंड ऑल अदर थिंग्स विच आर रिलेटेड दे आर योर्स सो वेन आई एम हियर Then I have to look after these things. These things does need some attention, some care. So I'm simply a servant, a guard, a servant who's taking care of these things, protecting for your service, not for any other purpose. And what to say of for my enjoyment. And only for your purpose, just to fulfill this purpose, I also have to earn some money. So I do that. But I'm very clear that not even one part or one cent of this money is meant for my enjoyment. I should use this money completely in this service so that they can all gradually endeavor and practice devotional service. And I also need to spend some money, and that is also in perfect harmony that is being used for your service, to gradually come close to you.
If wife is not in Krishna consciousness, then what should we do? We should support her or not? If father is not in that line, no relation. Is a husband not chanting, remembering that, and he is thinking that I am not servant of Ratanadal, servant of Krishna, then no relation. So all our relation will depend this, that he is eternal servant of Krishna. And he is doing like that, then I should serve him totally. Otherwise, we can give up our guru like Bali Maharaj. Bali Maharaj gave up his Gurudev. Shukracharya, you know. All the gopis have left their husbands. You know. Bharat Maharaj, he left his mother quickly in a moment. When he knew that he is against Ram, at once he came. You know, Vibhishan, he left his brother, Ravan. He was going to making a plan to quarrel with Ram. He left at once. So we see that all were happy. So our all relation should be centralized on this service of Krishna Valli. If anyone, a person was very friend to me. I was saying that he has been initiated from Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, your Prabhupada. So I was very friendly terms to him. But when he came to me, he was renounced also. But quickly when he gave up all these things, no relation, no chanting, became like Mayabadi, he came to me in a friendly term. But I told that our friendship was only based on Krishna consciousness. So now if you are not following, no friendship at all. For a moment I have no relation with you. So our relation should be that. If you want to develop your Krishna consciousness. Go on.
He says, O Mahaprabhu, I am very low. I do not understand what is better for me. I'm hearing, but yet because of my fallen condition, I'm unable to understand. How shall I ascertain what is favorable for me, what is not favorable for me? But yes, I surrender everything on you, that you please take care of myself. And I am just a protector, a servant. He's reminding again and again himself about his eternal position. And he says, thus, all these senses which are engaged in this worldly activities, may please you take care of them. You take the reins of these senses. You are the controller. I am just like a puppet. So, give me that strength that these senses may not indulge in any other activity which is against the bhakti and for your pleasure, as Srila Gurudev has explained. Strictly, if any relationship is coming against, we have to give it up because Krishna has ordered. This is Srinagati and we must follow, then only we can practice. Then, I shall not do anything for my sense pleasure. And everything I should dedicate for your service. Why? Because I understand. Your pleasure is the essence of all the pleasure for me. I know I can only be happy if I'm able to please you. And we also heard in Bhagavatam other day, Yayatma Samprasidati. Happiness can only be derived if we are able to please Krishna. In this world also we see, if I make happy other, those who are very close to me, then I feel happy. But because these relationships are self-centered and within trust, we don't get satisfaction. But real satisfaction will come, like Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, if you are trying to please Sriman Mahaprabhu, if you are trying to please Nityanand Prabhu, if you are trying to please Krishna, Srimati Radhika, then by their pleasure, automatically we'll feel happiness. And that's the essence of this song.
You know Ravan? He was worshipper of Lord Shiva. And he gave his head in fire sacrifice. And she became so happy and he gave him 10 heads. Eh? Always he was very pleased with Ravan, but when Ravan stolen away Sita, and he became what? Opposite to Ram, in opposition. And then what became? At once Shankar, Mahadev, he left Ravan and he was killed. In battle he never supported Ravan. You know Kans, Bhasmasur, or so many worshipping Shankar. And Shankar can't give anything, even Krishna Prem. And they were worshipping. But they became offender of Krishna or Ram. Then Shankar, at once he left them. And they were killed. So our whole, if you want to be a good devotee, our relation should be on that. Our honor to Vaishnava and Guru Bhai will depend how much he has faith in Gurudev and Vaishnava and how he is so much advanced devotee. Not like that he is my god brother if he is doing offensing, and even he is my god brother and he is superior to all. Never. Anyone in our family, Gaur family, chanting and remembering. However, it may be that he may be our Nityananda family, Janava family, Shamananda family, Narottam family, anyone. But we will should honor according to their qualification. And centralizing their relation to Krishna. If you want to. Anyone, very bosom friend, bosom of bosom, but it is not in Krishna consciousness. We have nothing to do with it. If you have friendship, then what will be? You will be degraded. So you should, what it has been told in Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he has told in this song, you should try to follow who are like a Grihastha Bhakta. It is very helpful. All doubts will go away. Nothing to think anything. You should follow. You should.
Madhuram, Madhuram, Madhuram.
of this song? Quickly. Let me solve it.
This is the glorification of Krishna by Sriman Vallabhacharya. He's saying that Krishna is the essence of all sweetness and the original Lord of all sweetness, and therefore everything about him is automatically sweet. That is, his lips are sweet, his face is sweet, his eyes are sweet, his smile is sweet, his heart is sweet, his walking is sweet, his voice is sweet, his character is sweet, his dress is sweet, his speech is sweet, his movements are sweet, his wandering is sweet. Everything about him is sweet because he's the essence of all sweetness. Then he goes on, his flute is sweet, his foot dust is sweet, his hands are sweet, his feet are sweet, his dancing is sweet, and his friendship is sweet. His singing is sweet, his drinking is sweet, his eating is sweet, his sleeping is sweet, and his beauty is sweet.
How his sleeping is sweet?
Because he dreams about Srimati Radha.
Yes. You are so expert. Everything explained?
His deeds are sweet, his acts of deliverance, that is, his liberating his devotees and demons are sweet. His love sports are sweet, his yawning is sweet, and even his chastisements are sweet. His garland of Gunja is sweet, his garland is sweet, his Jamuna river is sweet, her waves and her water and her lotuses are all sweet. The gopis are sweet, Krishna's all pastimes are sweet, his paraphernalia and ornaments are sweet, his food is sweet, his delight is sweet, and his embrace is sweet. So everything about him is all sweet because he is the embodiment of sweetness. His cows are sweet, his coward boys are sweet, his staff is sweet, his creation is sweet.
His mother is sweet, and his all sakhis are sweet, all friends are sweet.
And his defeating of demons is also sweet. Everything is sweet about him because he's the essence of all sweetness.
If you want to be sweet, what should you do? You should serve that sweet. For whole life you will be sweet. Gaur Pranam.
अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्विषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेत कृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहा पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणं भक्त्या विहीन अपराधलक्ष्ये क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम्
Srimad Bhagavatam, Dasama Skanda, 44 chapter. Again, you should come along me. Oh, we should go to Mathura. Krishna and Baldev are now Mathura, invited by Akru, through Akru. And there, Kans wanted to kill him. He had made an arena, but Krishna when came, by hearing the drum sound, with so many boys, and he wanted to enter in the arena, but Kuballya appeared, wanted to kill her. Quickly he finished and entered the arena, took the tusk of that elephant, some drops of blood, a very beautiful looking, like two baby lions. No fear at all. No fear. They entered in the arena where Charun Mustik and others were. And at once finished Charun Mustik and jump up the... he wanted to jump. And when he was going to finish Charun Mustik, then Nanda Baba was there. Vasudeva was there. Veki was brought there. Ugrasen Maharaj. From jail he was brought there. All were fearing so much. Now Krishna will be finished. Because he is a baby boy. And Baldev is also like baby. And they will finish here. And they took Krishna and Baldev Prabhu forcibly, Charuna and Mushti. And wanted to wrestle with them. At that time, the wives of Yadavas, of Mathura, they stood up and they were telling that here Kali has come and Adharma has come. We shouldn't be here. And if we are here, then we are admitting these things. We should not admit. Otherwise, sin will come also to us. So we should give up all the places. Oh, gopis are so fortunate. We are unfortunate. Krishna really is so beautiful in the whole world. Essence of all the beauties, all the madhurija, sweetness in Krishna. But we are unfortunate. We are seeing Krishna and Baldev here. But he is now going to wrestle with these demons. He is some angry, pushing them and by like this, in beer rush. Like a lion in cage, here we are seeing. But oh, if Krishna is in Vrindavan, gopis are how fortunate. Punyavata prajabhuo yadeng nilinga gudha Puran Puduso Banachitramalya Gapalayan Sabalas of Kanyan Sabenu Vikri Anchati Grit Ramachitangri. Have you this book, Swamiji? Prem Prayojan?
Swami
has. No, you have not. Achha, no. Punyavata prajabhuo. In this world, Braj Bhumi is certainly higher than any place and so glorious. Why? Because Krishna is here, Vrindavan. And especially, not only due to Krishna, due to gopis, not only due to gopis, among them Srimati Radhika is there. She is the essence of everything. She is the essence of Krishna, Madhurya, everything, beauty and everything, sweetness. Srimati Radhika is the essence of all. So, in whole three worlds, Brajbhumi is what?
Superior.
Topmost. Where? Nirlinga Gudha Purana Purusha Panachitra Malya. In a hidden way, secretly, oh Purana Purush, Supreme Personality of Krishna. Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigrahanadi Radha Govinda. She is moving here and there, walking and playing with boys, like friends with Braj ladies, like son, mother, this relation, everywhere. Gaha Palayan, always is nursing and supporting cows. Ga means so many meanings, all senses. That is why he is Rishikesh, he is called Rishikesh. And cows, Vedas, religious, knowledge, all kinds of. So Krishna is always supporting, nursing all. Sahabala, Vithabala Dev Prabhu, Karvansha Venu, playing on sweet venue. And by this, by sweet venue, attracting whole world. And Bikri Anchati, always playing in Vrindavan, Gokul, Nandagaon, Varshana. Namami Swaram Sachidananda Rupa Lasat Kundalam Gokule Vrajamana. Oh, Namami Swaram Sachidananda Rupa Lasat Kundalam Gokule Vrajamana. And Jasoda Matyan tato dutya gotya o namami swaram sachidananda rupa lasakundalam gokule vrajamana. All this playing here and there, like boys, not like God, like 400 Krishna, like Dwarka and Mathura. Giritra, here Shankar, Brahma, Rama, Lakshmi himself wants to serve the lotus feet of Krishna, but he has no chance. See the other side of Yamuna in Belban, Lakshmi even. He was charmed with Krishna and he left his husband Narayan in Vaikuntha. And she came with a greed that I must be in Vrindavan, playing in and dancing and singing in Raslila. But she was just taught by Yogamaya, oh, you cannot come. First you will have to be gopi, and then marriage with any gop, and then you can come. Otherwise, no. Oh, this is a very big problem. I cannot change my husband. I am Brahmani. Then you should be here. No entrance at all. So, even they want to worship, but they have no chance. Shankar wanted to worship that Krishna. He was tricky somewhat. She came on the border of Vrindavan. And he was worshipping Yogamaya. Yogamaya came, what do you want? Then, oh Mother Yogamaya, I want to see Vrindavan dance of Krishna Ras. Oh, have you done anything for this? No, I have not done anything. Then quickly he took that Shankar and he drowned in Brahmakund there. And then he came, when he came out, he became a very beautiful gopi, teeny age as 16 years. And then he told that you should be here and see. And when Ras was going, today no interest so much, no utsah. No. Krishna told Gopi by telling that why there is some defect. Any Vijatiya prashna has come. Vijatiya?
Outsider
have come. Then began to search. At last they saw that in a group, any new gopi was there. And they caught hold of that. Who are you? What is your name? But Jogmaya never gave him any name. What is the name of your husband? Or she was not married with any gopi. Who is your father? Jogmaya has not given all these things. He cannot give any answer of any question. And then all gopi began to... And his cheek was so swollen. And he began to, oh, Jogmaya, save me so. Then at once Jogmaya came and requested Krishna and gopi, oh, he is my disciple. Please be merciful. Then he became Gopishwar Mahadev. Then, from very far away, he saw the Ras, otherwise nothing. So Krishna is so higher. So your Gurudev has given relation to that Krishna, Gopijana Vallabha. You are so fortunate. Only this is the way, by chanting this Gopal mantra and Kam Gayatri, having the relation with Krishna, you can be gopi and then you can go to Braj, otherwise no way. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has told to Raya Ramananda, Sarup Damodar, also to all, Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, all Siksha, he has told like this. You are so fortunate to come in this line. So don't be weak, never be. Many, so many problems will come, but be like Himalayas, Everest, like Alps, not to go in there. Always serving Krishna. They are also glorifying. Gopas tapah kim acharan jada musmarupa. Lavanya sar asamodhananya siddham. Drigbhi pivantan savabhinamam durapa. Ekantadham jasasa sriya aishwarijasya. Oh, what gopis are so fortunate. What they have done in past life. What sacrifices. What tapa, astorage is there. If we will know, they are telling themselves that we must do that. Do you know what the gopis had done in past that they have become a gopi? Oh, nothing. They are Kaya Biva of Radhika. Badly manifestation of Radhika, not any Siddha. And some of are there, so thousand and thousand of birth, lakhs and lakhs birth. Gopal mantra and this Kam Gayatri mantra, by this, in Dandakaranya here and there. Lakhs birth. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here and he told that in a one birth you can do, be like that. You will have not to do so much practice of lakhs and lakhs birth. That is why he sent Rupa Raghunath, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and others to Swamiji, that if you want to be like that, oh, you will have not to do so much austerities like they did in Dandakaranya here and there. And one, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw in a glance and they became like, oh, Krishna, 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 Radhe, Radhe, we began to do. So you are so fortunate. But be fortunate. Be fortunate. Try to be. So they are telling you, certainly gopis glorious in whole world, that they are tasting the honey of beauty, lavanya. It may be money, anyone black, no harm. But there is lavanya.
Luster coming from within.
Like?
Pearls.
This is beauty. Krishna was blackish. But what was the lavanya sar? Beauty comes from inside. That in India we tell like pani, mukh par pani hai. Mukh par pani means lavanya. Ananya siddham, no use of ornaments or garments, beautiful, nothing. If a spot of ink will be here and there, of very beautiful, more beautiful. If dust of cow's feet is covered, oh, like powder, very more beautiful, more. If Krishna is naked, oh, more beautiful. In any way. So, they are telling, Drigbhi Pivanta, gopis always drinking the sweetness, that nectar of all these things. Durapameka ekanta dham jasasa sri ashwari. Who is he? He is the abode of all yasa, glory, fame, glory, shriya, of beauty, aswarjasa, all kinds of opulence, sweetness, mercy, everything Krishna. So you should try to know that your tumhara wo jo bhajaniya hai, worshipable deity, is not a very sadharan, ordinary person. No. They are telling that, oh, Gopiraj, most worshipable of us, that taking all the beauty like honey, but here what we are? Krishna is surrounded by so many enemies. And here he is somewhat angry mood, wrestling with others. We are not fortunate to see Krishna like gopis. Gopis are so glorious that always their minds and tongue is the chariot of Krishna. How? They are telling. Jadohane mahanane mathano palepa prankhankhanar virudito kshanamajjanado gayanti chainam manuraktathi o yasrukantho dhanna brajastriya urukramachitta jana. How gopis? You should try to follow them. Jadohane, when they are making little cows, what they are doing? Govinda damo dharma tuveti. Govinda damo dharma tuveti. Vahanane, with mushal and okhal. What? They are doing like this. Clearing rice, wheat, any grain. And they are doing with taal, as if when it goes down like mridanga, and there these bracelets like kartal, very sweet, and they are singing very sweet. Govinda damo dharma dhaveti, Govinda damo dharma dhaveti, milk, which has been made like dadhi, yogurt, and in big, big vessels. And they are but churning all. Govinda Damo Dharma Dhveti Govinda Damo Dharma Dhveti Govinda Damo Dharma Dhveti Govinda Damo Dharma. No problem at all, no problem. Nothing problem. Only remembering the pastimes of Krishna. And always doing this. Mathano palepa. They are observed in singing. Even Krishna comes, but they don't remember. Don't see Krishna. And then Krishna tells, oh, maya, maya, maya. What? Oh, tu ka kar rahi? What you are doing? Tears coming out of love and affection. And all the hairs standing, heart melting. So all are doing like this. Mathano, palepa, upalepan. They are brimming their houses. By hands. Hands is working. But mind is also working. What doing? And ten, Govinda Damo. Oh, there are some boys. Oh, they are weeping. Mother, mother. And they took at once and they were doing like what?
Petting them.
Govinda Ramo Dharma Dhveti. You should sleep. You should sleep. Not like that. Not telling any story of him. Only doing that. And hearing this in a very good tune, the boys used to, children used to sleep. And they're skipping again, churning. Govinda Rama. Their heart was quietly absorbed in Krishna Chintan, remembrance. Anurakta dhiyo asru kantha, asru, tears, noise, continuous. And kantha, they could not choke voice. Dhanya prajastya. They are telling, oh, glorious days. All Brajbala. All gopis are so glorious. Dhanya means fortunate soul. We are not fortunate. We are not seeing Krishna in this way. We cannot do here. Urukrama chitta jana. Urukrama, that Krishna always sitting very happily on the throne or any chariot of Krishna gopi's mind. Our gopis are sitting on the throne of Krishna mind always. Krishna always remember. Why? Where the bhakti will sing, he must be there. So Krishna always there. So in mind of Krishna, all gopis are always there. How fortunate. Again, Pratah Vrajata Vrajata Avishatasya Sayang Gobhi Shamang Kwanyato Ashani Samya Binu Nirgamya Turnamabala Patibhuri Panna Pashanti Sasmitamukam Sadaya Balukam. Oh, how fortunate gopis. In very morning, at about 9, when Krishna coming from his house, Yashoda house, with lakhs and lakhs friends and lakhs cows. And he is going to forest to cowherd. Then they sometimes on their top of houses, in front of their jangla khidki, window, sometimes standing on their door, sometimes in groves of the gardens, here and there. Very anurakta, very absorbed to Krishna, and they are taking darshan of Krishna. And when Krishna is returning from Kauhadi in the evening, all are seeing Krishna and so happy. And Krishna what doing? Sometimes becoming so nearer and he touches with his murli or vina there, this. And taking their all hearts, he comes to Braja. And then Jashoda Maiya what doing? Arati. All gopis are doing arati more than Jashoda Maiya. By there, and Krishna accepting, smiling. So gopis are so glorious. So and these are glorifying. Who? Mathura is glorifying. They have never gone there, Mathura. And anyone of Mathura. Only Krishna sent one of them, Uddhava, to see the glories of gopis and Nand Baba, Yashoda and all others. After that, Krishna and Baldev killed Charan Mustik and at last Kansa was killed. Then Krishna and Baldev came to Nanda Baba, where Nanda Baba was, on his bullock cart, nearby town of Mathura, outside. He was waiting for Krishna and Baldev, that when they will come, I will take them both and will return to Mathura, Vrindavan. First day after killing, all were with Krishna and Baldev. And Krishna and Baldev have no chance to meet Nanda Baba. But always thinking of Nanda Baba. Nanda Baba with cowherd boy was there waiting. One day, 2 days, went. Third day, anyhow, Krishna and Baldev came in night. There, Krishna and Baldev were sitting, right and left. Baldev Prabhu was in right way, here, and Krishna sat on him. Nanda Baba weeping bitterly. What you have decided? You have decided that you are son of Vasudeva and Devaki? No, father, we cannot decide. How we can have now? In dream even we cannot think like this. And both were weeping loudly. And Nanda Baba was also weeping. At last, Baldev Prabhu told, Baba, I want to come with Krishna with you to Braja. He told that, oh, I cannot tell you. I am not so cruel. You must be for some days here, because his whole sons has been killed by Kans. Now only you are alone, alive. So you should be here. He told that, without Krishna I cannot live a moment anywhere. Otherwise I will die. Then Nanda Baba asked Krishna, that what should I do? What should I do? Then Krishna told that, Father, if you will tell, I will be for some days with Baldev Prabhu to be here. And if Baldev Prabhu is going, then his father, mother, Vasudev Devaki and all Mathura Vasi will die. So I think it will be better that I should remain with Baldev Prabhu here. And after some time, when they will be pacified, then I will return quickly. They are your friends. I have no relation with them, only that they are your friend. You are my father. You are my everything. Now here, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur makes a Purva Paksha question.
Purva Paksha.
Putting a question before answering it.
That if Krishna is son of Nanda and Yashoda. Not of Vasudeva Devi. How he can be there? Anyone can live in a place where he receives more and more love and affection. Whether he is no son or son, this question secondary. But if he has so much high class of love and affection anywhere, he would like to be there. And undoubtedly, all Brajavasi, so much loving Krishna and Balde, more than anywhere. And it has been told in Srimad Bhagavatam, Nand Baba returned without Krishna and Balde. And also it is right, it is true that Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. How we can reconcile? How we can reconcile? Now you'll have to reconcile anyhow. When Nand Baba was weeping, Krishna became and Balde became of two kinds, in two forms. One Prakat Leela and one Aprakat Leela. Prakat Leela, Krishna and Balde were in Mathura. But Aprakat Leela, they came with Nanda Baba. Where? In Vrindavan. The son of Yashoda and Nanda Baba, Krishna, Brajendanandan, he returned with Nanda Baba. We know that Krishna never comes to Mathura, that Brajendanandan. His one form, one manifestation comes, like Vasudeva Krishna. So, in his bullock cart, Nanda Baba, he took Krishna and Balde with him. But that scene was not seen by anyone. And he came, returned to Vrindavan, to Nandagaon. And in one bullock cart, one Nanda Baba, manifestation of that Nanda Baba, was feeling so much separation and weeping. He returned to Mathura without Krishna and Balade. Like this. Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur has reconciled all these things. Very, very secret. Only high class of devotees can realize this. Otherwise, all the gopis, and gop will die at once in a moment. Yashoda Maiya also. So there are two things there, two leelas, pastimes there. Aprakat Leela and Prakat Leela both. Then, now I am coming to my point that I wanted to tell you. All these 6 days, what I told, it was like introduction. I wanted to give you some nectar of love of gopis, to whom even Uddhava could not taste. He came to Krishna and glorified. So after that, what became? Krishna went to Gurukul and I told all to you. And one day he was sitting on the roof of his palace. Yashoda, Devaki and Vasudeva all were there. And Krishna alone went on the roof of his palace. And he looked towards Vrindavan, north side, from Mathura. And he became so sad. And he began to weep bitterly. He saw that from here, Mathura he saw. His mother is weeping so bitterly. She had become blind. Now I've heard that all the cows are dying. So many died. Now all the cows are not taking milk from their udders of their mothers. Now cuckoos are not singing. Even peacocks not dancing because no Krishna. So he was looking all these things and he began to cry. Oh Jashoda Maiya, oh Nanda Baba, and he became, oh Gopis, oh Radhe, oh Krishna. And in the meantime, his bosom friend Uddhav came there, searching Krishna, and he saw that, oh Krishna is sitting there and weeping so bitterly. Here it has been told, Vishaninang Prabharo. Uddhav was most higher in rank in whole Mathura. He was so intelligent in all jagat. He was prime minister of Krishna. Daitaha, so much
near and dear.
Shakha, friend. Shishya, disciple. And Brihaspati, Sakshat Shishya. And he is told to be like Brihaspati. But more than Brihaspati. Brihaspati, the priest of demigods. And he came and saw Krishna with him. Krishna took his hands. Uddhava wanted to pacify him, but Uddhava has no words to pacify. Why Krishna is weeping? For whom he is weeping? Because at that time he has not known the glories of gopis. So he cannot realize what was virahanal separation fire in Krishna. And Krishna is burning. And anyone not qualified to save him. So he is burning. Uddhav came and told, why friend, you are weeping? And then Krishna took his hands in his hand and began to tell, Uddhav, Gacchho Uddhav, Brajam Samya, Pitri no Pritimavaha, Gopinang Mayo Vabidim, Masandeshar Vinocha. Uddhav, you are my friend. You are my prime minister. You are all in all. I know that you are more dear to my Baladev Prabhu, to Lakshmi, to others. More dear. Oh, you are my heart. I am your heart. And I don't know anyone. So I am telling this secret thing to you only. You should go to Braja, Vrindavan, Nanda, Gokul. Oh, Samya. Samya means? What is the meaning of? Samya means like soft. What?
Soft and pleasing like the moon.
Samya? Pritrir, no. He is telling himself. Pritrir, no. Our father. Krishna may tell his father, but why is he telling that our father? He thinks that Uddhava is my brother. And who is father? Pitra, here mother and father both. For Jashoda and Nanda. He is in Mathura, in the palace of Vasudeva Devaki. They are there. But he is telling to Uddhava, my father and my mother, Jashoda and Nanda, are very unhappy, feeling separation, like fire. You must go there. Pritimabaha, you should pacify them. No? If Krishna is son of Vasudeva and Devaki, why he is telling? Now Uddhava now heard that, oh, really? I know that Krishna is son of Vasudev and Devaki. But why Krishna is telling like so? Oh, it may be that partly he will be the son of Vasudev Devaki. No how? Partly. But fully, he is son of Vasudev and Nanda and Devaki. You should know. Swamiji has sometimes, in beginning he has written like this, that he was a adopted son of Devaki and Nanda. But after that he has admitted all these things. And not admitted, he knew this fact. And gradually and gradually, like Sukadeva Goswami has told, he follows Sukadeva Goswami. So really, all Brajavasi know that Krishna is son of Nanda and Yashoda, not of Vasudeva. Now he became some, what, wonder. That, oh, now Krishna is admitting that Krishna is son of Nanda and Yashoda. Yashod pacified him. Why he Krishna told first to mother and father? That Uddhava should know. My father and mother are so dear, but more secret thing is that my most dearest are gopis. So that is he is telling. Gopi nam mayo mad biyoga vading matsandeshai vimochaya. He should go. Taking my message to gopis. Gopis are of feeling so much separation, so much more than Nanda and Yashoda. So you should go and pacify them, not with your logic, not your tattva, not your intelligence. By what? Anyone can pacify, giving by only words. So, what I am telling to you? Matsandesha, my message only, the words of my message. You should tell as it is, I am telling. Not mixing anything, not a single word. And you should go to gopis and tell. Then they may be pacified. How the gopis are? Krishna is admiring, glorifying gopis with his own mouth. Tam man manashka. Mat prana. Madathe taita daihaka. Here is the glory of gopis. Krishna himself admitting and telling. I think that there is none in whole this world that they can glorify gopis like Krishna. Only Krishna can do. And he could not glorify him them so high. That is why he took the beauty and mood of Radhika to know the glories of Gopi. And he made his guru Vishakha Devi, Shiksha Guru. And then he knew something. Now in the shape of, in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he can glorify more than Krishna even. Only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had not descended to this world, anyone has no any idea of glorifying gopis, especially Radha and Krishna also. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And we are so lucky to come in his life, in his line. So much. He is telling, Ta manmanaska, all the gopis. Manmanaska, what is the meaning of manmanaska? They have engaged their whole mind. Observed, they are totally absorbed in me. Nothing else in day and night, 24 hours. They think of me and they have all already absorbed in me. How? That I tell a story? What a story? You should tell in brief. You don't remember? Oh, you?
Once there was a newly married gopi who came to Nandagaon and her mother-in-law was stopping her to come out and take darshan of Krishna. But then she came, and when Krishna was coming back from the forest after grazing cows, then he pinched one of the calves in such a way that he ran towards that gopi who was looking towards Krishna. And Krishna, in order to come and take the calf back, he came and he touched the cheek of the gopi with his flute and quickly ran back. And now this gopi was stunned. She was looking like a statue because her heart was completely taken over by Krishna. So after some time, her mother-in-law came and she saw that the this gopi was standing and wasn't doing anything. So she shook her and told her, I told you not to see Krishna and you did obey me. Now you see, you cannot do anything. You are completely useless. And then she strongly with anger took her in and gave her some engagement. First, she gave her some pot and yogurt to churn. And then what was happening? Instead of churning the yogurt, she has mustard seeds in the pot and she was trying to churn them. And after a while, when her mother-in-law again came, and then she noticed and she again spoke with harsh words and said, now I know you cannot do anything because you have been bitten by the black snake. Okay, I must make some other arrangement to bring you back to normal consciousness. And then she gave one rope in her hand and so many pots and also so many pots on head, and then gave also one child to go and bring water from the well. And all the bridge ladies, they are habitual that they can carry so many pots, 1, 2, 3, 4 on their head, and they can also walk towards the well. So as this gopi came to well, then she took off all the pots and she kept the child on the wall of the well, and she made the rope, the knot, and instead of giving that knot, that rope on the one of the pots, she gave that in the neck of the child. Because she's completely absent-minded. She doesn't know. She's not in her external consciousness. And then as she was doing that and about to drop the child in the well, all the other gopis, they shot it and they said, oh, stop, what are you doing? And then one of them said, oh, she must have been haunted. And another gopi said, no, she's not been haunted. She's completely taken over by Krishna. That's why she's completely forgotten herself. Because her mind has completely absorbed in Krishna's thought, she's unaware of her any engagement whatsoever, and this is one of the example of what
we are doing. Man manashka mat prana. I am there. What pran means life, and that is why gopis, when Krishna came from Vrindavan and came to Mathura, then they would have been dead without Krishna, but they were not dying. Why? Because Krishna was their life, their prana. So they were not dying. And also, mat prana, all the gopis are my life. Not my priya, my life, Krishna, all the gopis are. Madarthe takta deihakar. For me, they have given up all their deha and daihik, everything. Their decoration, their taking, anything, and all jobs they have left for me. Mameva daitam, I am only their beloved, no one other. Prishtam, their dearest. Manasa gata, totally absorbed in me. Ye takta lok dharmansha madarthe tan vibhagmyam. They have given up their all kinds of shyness, dharma, pranasham dharma, everything, their husband, everything for me. So I must, unko paan poshan karunga. I must support and nourish them. Those who have left everything for me, those who leave everything for me, in any time, I must nourish them and serve them. This is his promise. So you should always remind this. If you are giving up all things, worldly things, and always remembering Krishna, observing Krishna, then you should be not in any doubt that Krishna will surely support you and nourish you. So don't be worry for your supporting, nourishing and anything. We are depending on our relatives, but at the time of death, they cannot support, they cannot save us, but Krishna can save us. So he is telling that I must support and nourish. Oh, that is why you must go there. Maita priyasam preshthe durasthe gokula striya smaranto ang bimoyanti birah kontha bipala. I'm here. And there, feeling so separation mode. They cannot do any job, nothing, even taking any remnant of prasad or anything. Always they are waiting for what? Oh, Krishna has told and promised that I am coming day after tomorrow. So all are only waiting for that. They are thinking that, oh, day after tomorrow, day after tomorrow. Krishna has told, so when day after tomorrow come? When? They are thinking that, oh, Krishna has told, so day after tomorrow, tomorrow. Tomorrow, tomorrow. And they are waiting. All the gopis are not entering in Braj, their houses. Where they are? In forest of Nandagaon. Kadambater or Uddhav. Uddhav Kyari or Kadamba Kyari. Anyone cannot see. Only by the grace of Krishna, mercy of Krishna, or Yog Maya, only Uddhav Sade. Dharayanti ati krishnena praya pranana kathanchana pratyagamana sandeshe palabhyome madatmika. Only they are getting their life that Krishna has promised that he will come. And they know that Krishna must come. But when coming? Tomorrow. That is why they are. That when Krishna will come and we will die, then that he will not see us and then he will also die. So only to please Krishna, that Krishna should not be unhappy. They are anyhow keeping their lives. So you should go there. Then he gave his Vaijayanti mala. He gave his golden crown. He gave him garments. Saffron cloths and also the chariot of Kansa, golden. And he was going in the way with Uddhav, telling all these things, how gopis are, how Nanda Baba is and all other things. But Uddhav saw that it will be very late, so himself he went on the chariot and sat there. And he wept the horses and they began to fly. Krishna was still there, standing. He was looking towards Rath. And after that, when Rath was out of his sight, then he was looking towards the dust. And when dust was also subsided, only he was thinking of gopis and gopis. Then anyone come and he took away to Krishna. Gaur Pramana. Then we will begin or tomorrow. But how Uddhav went there and what dialogue was there and what he saw there. So only you will hear and try to remember all these things. These are all the glories of Gopi, especially the glory of Srimati Radha. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came only to give all these things. And that is why he gave it to Rupa Goswami, and he gave to Jiva Goswami, and Sanatana Goswami Mahaprabhu gave, and thus Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur too. And then they expressed in the explanation of Srimati Mahaprabhu. You should try to remember all these things. This is called bhajan. Gaur Pramana.
This pastime is also only in this Prakat Leela, not in the Prakat Leela.
After that. Yeah, what is that? Any drama today? Any? Eh? Oh, very good, very good. You should wait. Very good drama is coming.
Three left. Okay.
What?
Mother of Sudevi.
Name?
Same name. Manavarandevi Dasi. Dira Dasi. Oh, then Bhakta Guillaume, please stand up. He left also. Then, what is name? Ghanashyam.
Oh, Ghanashyam Prabhu ki.
Dira Dasi. Also left? Okay. Then, Adrian Haynes, please stand up. Adrian?
He has gone.
He has also gone? Advaita Das.
Advaita Das Prabhu ki.
Jai. Thank you. Ramesh Prabhu, you want to say something?